Ladies and gentlemen, what's going on? It's your boy
Eli. In your window.
If you don't get it, we in your window. But if you with it, when it's finished, in the end, you win. Dough, man. Let's go.
Back at it like a bad habit.
Reacted to Eminem KillShot. Still feel like Rap Devil was not as good as KillShot. I've had a lot of people tell me otherwise, but like, how? Like, you look, listen to the songs. Like, forget the artists themselves. Like, if Eminem put out Rap Devil and MGK put out KillShot and it was the same lyrics and all that stuff, people would be saying KillShot was still better. So I don't understand that. Let's just get it. Like a bitch, shut the fuck. First thing I do want to mention, like, how he did put him in a little scope or whatever, which a lot of stuff MGK said in the Rap Devil song was saying, like, he gonna have him in the scope. So he had him in the scope. He got the man bun, stuff like that. His eyes, like, crossed out, like he shot him, aiming, like, little smiley face right there. He's aiming for his skull, like he got him in his shots. And this is the kill shot. He's aiming at him and keep playing. He's gonna pull that trigger, like, you're right there. And then this song is basically saying, like, this is gonna, like, end his career. And if you've seen how MGK's career has been going so far, it feels like his career has already ended. But that's just my opinion.
You sound like a bitch, bitch.
Shut the fuck up.
Fans become your haters.
You done?
Beard's weird.
All right.
You yelling at the mic. Weird,
weird. Doing this once.
Beard's weird. Why you yelling at the mic?
Obviously, the beginning part was just kind of making fun of MGK's Rap Devil, like, stuff where he was saying. It was like, your beard's weird. Yelling at the mic. You sound like a bitch, bitch. Just, like, stuff or whatever. Like, a little couple stuff that he said. But he kind of, like, used it as, like, a little intro thing or whatever. It's like, bro, like, what are you talking about? Like, okay, you want to keep talking smack? Okay, let's do it then. You want to do it, so.
Rihanna just hit me on a text. Last night I left hickeys on her neck. Wait, you just dissed me? I'm perplexed. Insult me.
Now, I want to say, like, a lot of artists do exaggerate and stuff like that. Like, I can imagine Rihanna hitting him on a text, but maybe not the hickeys on her neck, okay? Eminem, I feel like he would probably be that guy to probably do something like that, but I don't think to Rihanna. Like, they're such good friends, but I feel like he only did that because of a line MGK probably said in the Rap Devil song, whatever. That was Eminem. I would have that dog in me, so, like, I'd definitely be leaving hickeys on her neck. You know, I already did that last night. Not to Rihanna, to another girl, but let's continue.
The line compliment me on the next. Damn, I'm really sorry you want me to have a heart attack. Insult me in a line, compliment me on the next. Damn.
And most of the Rap Devil song and stuff just sounded more like a insult, compliment. It seemed like MGK was confused when he was rapping about Eminem's. Like, one hand he was like, "You're the greatest rapper alive," and then, like, small threat, like, small, like, dishes, like, freaking dweeb. All you do is read the dictionary and stay inside. And, like, he said, like, compliment his albums and stuff, but then also try to say you suck. Like, it's just like, I get it's hard to go after your idol, somebody you admire, or whatever. But if you're going to go after somebody, go after them right or don't do it at all. Like, he really was trying to capitalize on this. And realistically, it didn't do anything for him. His Binge album sunk even worse. He didn't make any money from that. And he's been going downhill from then. Like, I have probably haven't even heard a new MGK rap song in a minute. He's just been switching genres and genders and just not even caring what he does next. He's just afraid to go back to rap, and I wouldn't blame him either.
I'm really sorry you want me to have a heart attack. Was watching 8 Mile on my Nauta track. Realized I forgot to call you back.
Here's an autograph for your daughter. I wrote it on a starter cap.
I like the little stand line of, here's an autograph for your daughter. Like his daughter is Stan Mitchell, and he's like Stan's older brother or whatever. Like, they're both obsessed over Eminem. In a way, like, saying that. That's kind of the line I got.
Stan, son, listen, man, dad.
Then he called him Stan. Perfect.
Daughter, I wrote it on a starter cap.
Stan, son, listen, man, dad isn't mad, but how you gonna name yourself after a damn gun and have a man bun?
Listen, that whole, I personally, he wanna talk about his beard. They only thought it was weird for the simple fact Eminem never had a beard before. He's getting older. I think it looks but basically I think it looks different. It was cool when he first did it, and now he's had it for quite some time, so it's good to have a different kind of version of Eminem. I just hope he doesn't dye it blonde like his hair Or maybe all blonde hair and beard might look cool. I don't know. Or maybe it might be weird. I don't know. But yeah, I think it definitely look better than the man bun thing. Like, come on now.
Giant smoke, eyes open, undeniable. Supplying smoke, got the fire stoke. Say you got me in a scope, but you graze me. I said I'm calling in a scope, and you swayzy. Your reply got the crowd yelling, woo. So before you die, let's see who could out-petty who with your corny lines.
Slim your old
Al Kelly, ooh, but I'm 45, and I'm still outselling you.
Facts. He definitely outselling Machine Gun Kelly. That's why, like, I always, people who are on Machine Gun Kelly's top, even if you say I'm an Eminem stan, whatever the case you want to say, like, I go off of things that make sense, logic. Like, you, if you tell me you think somebody raps better than Eminem, whatever the case is, I can say they're probably on the same, like, you got to compare the two on the same level first to see who stacks higher. And I can get, okay, I think this song's better, or I think Eminem's verse is better, or his verse is better, whatever. MGK is not on Eminem's level. Like, if we just talking about rapping fast alone, maybe Tech 9, but as far as, like, versatility and storytelling and stuff like that, it was Kanye and Jay-Z. Jay-Z doesn't really put as much music out. Kanye has gone crazy, but his music production-wise was on that level. And there's some new artists and stuff coming out that's being kind of, like, pretty, like, versatile with this stuff. So maybe Kendrick Lamar, maybe, but definitely not MGK. Like, I, come on now, that's what?
By 29, I had three M's at a
Little Wayne.
Blue. Now let's talk about something I don't really do. Going in someone's daughter's mouth, stealing food. But you're a fucking molehill. Now I'm gonna make a mountain out of you.
Okay, first of all, you said how you had a couple albums already blue at 29, but Machine Gun Kelly at his age is not as successful. Also, too, I realized this whole daughter starter cat line, and then taking stuff out of your daughter's mouth or whatever, it was like another lie, because apparently MGK did say that he tried to, like, in an interview, I believe, said he tried to take, like, food out of his daughter's mouth, whatever, just because it wasn't trying, like, he was just doing, it just, MGK felt like he was doing stuff to mess up his career in the business, because they was almost, they was pretty much under the same record label, just different bosses, if that makes any sense.
Ho chill, acting like you put the chrome barrel to my bone marrow, gonna bitch you ain't a bow and arrow, say you run up on me.
Gunna bitch, you ain't a bow and arrow. I like that. That's actually kind of
like a phone bill spraying lead, playing dead. That's the only time you hold still.
And probably one of the best lines ever. Eminem didn't even go that hard on MGK, and he still kind of killed him.
Eating cereal or oatmeal? What the fuck's in the bowl? Milk, Wheaties or Cheerios?
Cause I'm taking a shit in them, Kelly. I need reading material.
Dictionary. Yo, Slim.
And I felt like this whole song, Eminem kind of just took everything MGK said and spin it back around on him, or spin it on his head. So that's why I think this went a whole lot better. And MGK even himself said he had a clip in the holster, but he had to put it back because he was kind of like, he heard Killshot and he had to put it back. And I'm like, that doesn't even make any sense. If you don't think Killshot was that good, but, like, you keep responding to any and every little thing Eminem related, Haley, like, you just all of a sudden Eminem put Killshot out, and you just think, oh no, Rap Devil was way better, and that Eminem put Killshot out, and it wasn't that good, so I don't have to put anything out. That doesn't make any sense. That doesn't make any sense at all. Clearly, if you didn't think his writing skills, his penmanship was good when he did the Not Unlike verse calling you out, you wouldn't have said nothing to begin with, but you felt the need to say something. So when he came back and clapped back at you on all the stuff that you said in your Rap Devil song, you kept quiet, and he was like, you know what? I'm going to talk about it in an interview, but I'm not going to do another song. Because low-key, he's afraid. Like, when do people going to understand that? Like, he's not tough for not putting another song out just because he claimed that he's not. And then he's switching genres and genders. Like, nah.
Your last four albums suck. Go back to recovery. Oh, shoot. That was three albums ago.
What do you know? Oops.
Know your facts before you come at me, little goof. Luxury. Oh, you broke, bitch. Yeah.
That was another line him talking about, your last four album stocks go back to recovery. Oh shoot, that was three albums ago. Like, he basically just talking about all his stuff and, like, clowning it, basically saying, like, not all that stuff you said, and that's, like, you're not making no sense. You thought you was nice, but you're not.
You broke, bitch, yeah. I had enough money in 02 to burn it in front of you, ho. Younger me, no, you'd have whacked me. It's funny, but so true. I'd rather be 80-year-old me than 20-year-old you.
till I'm hitting old age. Still can fill a whole page with a 10-year-old's rage. Got more fans than you in your own city, little kitty, go play. Feel like I'm babysitting Lil Tay. Got the ditty okay, so you spent your whole day shooting a video just to fucking dig your own grave. Got you in your own wake, I'm the Billy Goat. You ain't never made a list. Next to no Biggie, no Jay. Next to Taylor Swift and that Iggy Ho. You a-
Taylor Swift and Iggy? I could see MGK being a, like, more on that level. And I don't even mind MGK. Like, I listen to a lot of his older songs, but it's just not the same no more. I listen to all kind of artists and stuff. For me to enjoy an artist, I have to listen to, like, 90 to 95% of their catalog for the most part, and I find too many stuff I don't like. But MGK, I can't. And I get the people who want to be fans of MGK or want to be fans of Eminem. It's not about that, like I said. MGK's song was not that good. Like, I said it, bro. Like, you can't keep pretending you live in fantasy land in Narnia where just the Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe and everything you say is just gonna magically just become reality. Like, it's like, this is just facts. Like, it's not, like, come on now. I can't believe people really think people keep hyping up MGK in the worst ways possible. Give him his props when he actually does good. If I put out a song and it's terrible, it's terrible. Don't be like, oh, see, even Eli rap better than Eminem. What? Bro, shut up.
We're about to really blow, Kelly. They'll be putting your name next to Chai, next to Benzie.
Just because you hate Eminem don't mean that I rap better than him. Like, that don't make sense.
They'll be putting your name next to Chai, next to Benzie. No lie, motherfucker, like the last motherfucker saying alien vein, alien brain.
Satanist. Yeah. My biggest flops are your greatest hits.
The game's mine again and ain't nothing changed but the lock. So before I slay this bitch, I'm gonna give Jade a kiss. Gotta wait.
Before I slay these locks, give Jade a kiss, the locks and cutting the hair and everything like that before he go back to his roots or whatever, which locks and all that stuff. I like that. It all ties in together.
Wake up, Labor Day to this. Being rich, shamed by some nick. Using my name for clickbait in a state of bliss. Cause I said his goddamn name. Now I got a cop back aim. Yeah, bitch, pop champagne to this.
It's your moment. This is it.
As big as you're gonna get,
so enjoy it. Had to give you a career to destroy it.
Lethal injection, go to sleep 6 feet deep. I'll give you a B for the effort. But if I was 3'11", you look up to me. And for the record, you would suck a dick to fucking be me for a second.
If I was 3'11", you would still look up to me. And for the record, you would suck a dick to fucking be me for a second. Come on now, like, come on. And we already know Eminem go way worse in those, like, Ja Rule, cannabis diss and stuff. Like, come on now. So he went easy on MGK.
Lick a ball sack to get on my channel. Give your life to be a solidified. This motherfucking shit is like Rambo when he's out of bullets. So what good is a fucking machine gun when it's out of ammo? Had enough of this tatted up mumble rapper. How the fuck can him and I battle? He'll have to.
He called him a tatted up mumble rapper. Bro, that's the whole. Come on now, the whole song is just like. I like this about Eminem, like, so, like, most songs, I don't mind listening to, like, Eminem songs, but I like to hear the songs where he's just kind of, like, going in, he's killing whatever, he's not really rapping fast, he's kind of just chopping it up, killing and stuff like that. I don't mind when he raps fast or when he puts a lot of words that rhyme together in one thing, like, that's cool. But this Eminem just rapping like a regular rapper is, like, the best because it shows, like, Eminem can do, like, however... And still kill it. Like, he's versatile, and that's the thing that people don't understand. Now, I give it to MGK props that he able to, like, venture off and see what else is going on out there in the world. But people can't act like he didn't just do that right after KillShot. Like, he really fell flat.
The fuck Kim and my flannel. I'll give him my sandals, cause he knows long as I'm shady, he's gonna have to live in my shadow.
As long as I'm shady, he's gonna have to live in my shadow. That's probably just one of the... That's tied... for being one of the best lines ever. But definitely the shading and shadow, I thought that was nice. The 4'11" or 3'11" line was right type too. Like, come on now, that whole, I feel like I got tongue twisted thing going on, but yeah, that line was tough too.
Letting off on my offspring like a gun barrel, bitch, get off me. You dance around it like a sombrero. We can all see you fucking salty cause young Gerald's balls deep inside a Halsey.
Talking about his ex, like he's not playing no games.
Your red sweater, your black leather.
You dress better, I rap better.
That a death threater, a love letter. Little white toothpick things.
Yeah, death threater, a love letter.
This is over a pick.
This other song he put out, the Rap Devil song. Definitely sound like MGK can pick a lane.
This
don't like you, prick. Thanks for dissing me. Now I had an excuse on the mic to write, not a light. But really, I don't care
who's in the right, but you're losing the fight you picked. Who else won it? Kales, button, fails, button, L's, fucking nails. In these coffins as soft as cotton nails. Kill shot, I will not fail. I'm with the doc still, but this idiot's boss pops pills and tells him he's got skills. But Kales, the day you put out.
Pops pills and tell him he's got skills. Okay, I like that.
Hits the day Diddy admits that he put the hit out that got pop kill, eh?
Which is a very controversial line that people still was like, damn, that's crazy. Did that really happen? And Diddy came out acting like he really was about to come out and do something. He ain't come out and do nothing. Like, come on now.
I'm sick of you being whack and still using that motherfucking autotune. So let's talk about it. I'm sick of you.
Yeah. And you know, Eminem uses autotune too, but MGK sounds way worse, especially in that Binge album. Oh my gosh. Kill.
So let's talk.
Shot.
Talk about it. Talk about it. I'm sick of your mumble rap mouth. Need to get the cock about it before we can even talk about it. I'm sick of your blonde hair and earrings. Just cause you look in the mirror and think that you're Marshall Mathers. Don't mean you are and you're not about it. So just leave my dick in your mouth and keep my daughter out of you. Fucking. Oh. And I'm just playing, Diddy. You know I love you.
I feel like he was gonna say you fucking bitch. But that was kind of the extent of it. But if you guys enjoyed this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, baby. Share with your friends. I'm putting videos out every single week, pretty much every single day. Roll to 1,000. Let's get it in. I'm gonna go ahead and edit this video, have it ready for you guys, but I got plenty of other videos on the works. So other than that, I will catch you guys in the next minute. Stay tuned for more videos to come, and like I said, I will be posting on my commentary channel and my gaming channel as well. But we're getting back into the video, so thank you guys so much for rocking with me. And have a blessed day, man. Love you guys always. Peace out and all that fun stuff. Bye.